All right, you guys, we're back here doing the part two to the build for the F-117 stealth fighter. You can see we had our plans. Like I said, I got new marks on here for 45 degree cuts with an arrow pointing out, which means you're gonna cut outside the main airframe, and it's marked everywhere. So from now on, you'll know which way to cut on your piece. All right, so picking up where we left off, I was taping all my parts that I had cut out together. I went ahead and applied some blue tape where I needed to put this here. I was gonna go ahead and start clear taping some of this. Again, I quit using the hot glue gun. It's just, I think the hot glue weighs too much for these planes. On here. What I'll do is I'll just clear tape a lot of this and come back and stick some foam safe glue where I want it. Alright, so now I'm going to do some touching up with some foam safe. Make sure you're not using a lot of foam safe glue. So just wherever I ain't got the blue tape, I'm gonna start doing some foam safe glue. And in all these cracks on your, where you scored it and you bent it, you wanna get some foam safe glue down in those. Because later on we're gonna cut a canopy out of here. I want it to be nice and stiff. Just get a good amount all up in through here, through these tops. If you got any sticking out over, just smooth it out. And this foam glue will add some strength to it. Just rub it on there like so. Alright, now I'm gonna remove some of this blue tape I stuck on here. I use the blue tape because it comes off real easy. It doesn't take no foam with it. These pieces off here and I'll apply some more foam safe glue. I just used the blue ones to get a quick mock-up going. Again, you don't have to install your electronics. I'll just take you through the steps I do to... You don't have to install your electronics until after you get it painted here. So, alright, wherever I remove that clear tape, now I'm going to hit it with some foam safe glue down on those cracks. I'm trying to stay away from that hot glue gun. Just one of those sticks weighs quite a bit. Again, you want to wipe off any of your excess foam glue. Want everything, all your tape to go on nice and flat. did that, let's go ahead and start putting some clear tape on here. Finish up clear taping all the spots that I didn't hit yet. Find you want to get your tape on there nice and flat. When you do, your paint job will turn out nice and smooth. So I'll lay like this side down and then push it in with my nail. Alright, now we're gonna cover up the all these little cracks we made with when we scored it. And here you really wanna make sure you do a nice job covering them because your paint's gonna show through real nice on any cracks you leave open. Don't be afraid to apply enough tape. And this is going to stiffen all this up too, so when we cut our canopy into it, it'll look real nice. Sure you get them all. Yeah, I could use a whole roll of this scotch tape and it won't even come close to weighing as much as one of them glue guns. One of them sticks from that glue gun got some weight behind them. And as you can see, it gets really strong. Finish up my top. Try to rush through this so I don't have to make a part three video. Now that we have that installed, let's go ahead and cut out our air intakes now. Again, that's all I do is I cut them out of my plans. Again, we didn't cut these out in the beginning because this piece would have just been real flimsy. Get these out of the way. I'll just stick this piece right where it belongs. Line it up real nice. Alright, once you line it up really nice where it belongs, just go ahead and mark your corners. Two of these are for the air intakes for the EDF unit. The other two, I designed this stealth fighter to where it'll take in air from the intakes, and then it compresses it down in the back when it comes out of the exhaust, and it works as like a drag rudder. All right, so we can move this off to the side and just go ahead and mark out our lines. We just playing some connect the dots here. Actually, I'm just gonna freehand this stuff. I'm sure you probably can too. We can go ahead and cut these out. Again, you can just freehand a lot of this stuff. Alright, so once you cut out your air intakes, now we're going to want to install our jet intake covers. And you'll see they just line up. You want the front to line up here with your main leading wing edge here. And this should be flush with your top. So I'll go ahead and move it back and move it around until I find what I'm looking for. Is like right there. I'll go ahead and clear tape this right where I got it here. Again, make sure it's nice and the piece is nice and lined up flush. Again, this should be lined up with your front piece here. Now these should just fold down right where in the spot they're in. Alright, I'm not even going to bother cutting out the ducts on the other side. I already went through it with you. We're just going to install the other side. Again, you just want to make sure it's flush with the top up here. Again, all this tape is going to cover up any of those cuts we made that all the cracks were showing. You just want to make sure they're both even. Looking good. Lay a piece on here. Anywhere you think that the tape's going to get bound up, I just go ahead and make some relief cuts. Don't forget to cover all the cracks because it'll show up in your paint. Make sure you cover them all. Looks like I got all those. Still missing a piece there. You guys are going to want to take your time applying your tape, that way you get all the cracks covered. I'm just kind of rushing through this here. Alright, this was a piece earlier I forgot to cut out of the nose. So I went ahead and cut it out at the angles it told me. I even went back and scored off a little bit on the back sides so it'll sit flatter. Just like so. I'm going to go ahead and foam glue, safe glue this, and I'll run tape over it later. I want the nose of the plane to be strong in case I come in for any nose ins. Hold that there for a second. I'll do some clear taping over that. Yep, clear tape is the way to go, guys. Anywhere you can just use it, use that and foam safe glue, then you're saving all that weight on that hot glue. Alright, now for up here, I'm going to be cutting a canopy hatch in here, so I got to beef this up with some tape. Again, go over all your cracks, make sure you ain't missing none. Which I see I am over here. I have to get my tape on there nice and straight. Side over here. Alright, you guys, so there we got our top pretty much all set. Just another one. Again, don't be afraid to put some tape on there, beef everything up. You're going to be painting over it anyway. guys. I kind of rushed, so I'm gonna go back and flatten out some of these spots when I put my paint job on there. Just use my nail to flatten them down. Alright, looks like I got all my seams all covered. I see a piece of high tape. I'll just take and give a little cut. Alright, now installing these little thrust tube spreaders. You're going to want to wait till you cut out for your thrust tube, because I don't know if you're going to use a 28 or a 30 millimeter. Just go ahead and wait on those for a second. Just go ahead and cut out for that thrust tube right now. Again, I'm cutting out for the 28 millimeter. So I'm gonna go on the inside lines of my plans. Always keep your plans handy. Don't go throwing them out too early or nothing. Alright, so we're going to cut out for the EDF unit. Just take my plans and lay them on here. Make sure they're nice and centered. Once it's centered, take and mark it. Connect these dots. Should get it right on there. A lot of the stuff I use, I get from the dollar store. These rulers are great because you can hold them from the top. All right, here I was already working on a thrust tube. Show you what I did. I cut out my kid's coloring book cover. Just like a paper material. You get that at the dollar store too. Let me show you how you make one of these things. I cut it out to the 3 3/4 inches that I needed. It's on your plans. You can wrap it up around there. Stuff works great for making thrust tubes. Again, I put the EDF fan housing right inside the middle, and I just use my fingers to finish up the rest. There you go, you can push your EDF out of there. Alright, so let's so if you were to measure 3.5 inches back, you want to leave this piece on for now and cut it out later. Alright, let's go ahead and cut out for this. This is for my thrust tube and my fan. I made sure I cut it a little short because I want to make sure I don't cut it too big in the beginning. Trim some of this out of here. And with this F-117, your thrust tube is going to hang out the bottom more than It is the top because it's such a small jet. It's like packing a Hemi engine in a little Volvo or something. So you can't bury it all the way down in there. So I'm just gonna take off a little bit more. Just give me a little extra room. Gonna make a little bit on both sides. All right, so there we'd have our thrust tube. Just go ahead and put a couple pieces of tape just to hold it on there for now. I found too that you can just tape your thrust tubes on. You don't have to use hot glue neither. I mean, that way if you want to build another jet later on down the road, you can just take the whole thrust tube right off. So there's about how your thrust tube's gonna look. All right, now we can slide these spreaders on up inside the back here. Well, actually we can finish off cutting off this back. Well, let's just wait on that and add these pieces in here. Again, these are just, they spread out the exhaust in the back. Then your vertical stabilizer fins will rest on them real nice. You're gonna open this up. You want them on them lines there. Set them in there where I need them. Just like so. You want the angle in the back coming down toward to meet up with this piece. Just get them in there as straight as you can. Let's do the other. And you want to line them up with those lines that you already had on the bottom of the plane. Sometimes these things are a little tricky. So just go with it. Get them in there nice and straight. Being a little tough. There we go. There they are. They just spread out your exhaust tubes.